against us because today we're the winning ones. We don't know that we're the children of God. We like our oppressive names or nationalities, or you're African American, or you're Haitian, or you're Colombian, Puerto Rican, Dominican. We like our pet names because they all came together and destroyed us and gave us new definitions, so we don't identify with our book anymore. But we don't. They have said, come, let us cut them off from being a nation. The nation said, and he's going to reveal who by the God-given name, because the names they go by today is not the names God gave them, right? But he said, their goal was to cut off God's people from being a nation. My sister, the only time we're showing love to one another is when we're keeping the commandments. You understand that? And a basic commandment that we just read. Read that again in Sirach. Here's a basic commandment. Read that. Sirach, chapter 12 and verse 10. Never trust thine enemy. You hear what God says? Never trust our enemies. My sister, my name is Ringo Will. I got an important question for you two, right? You've been around for a while, right, sister? You spent some time on this earth, right? Do we have enemies? Who's our enemy, sis?
The white
power. The what? The Caucasian power. What's your name, by the way, sis? My beloved sister Crystal said, the Caucasian, the European system, right? So she's saying the European are our enemies. Sister, you know God recorded that?
Right.
And we're going to bring that out. My sister, what's your name?
Deborah.
Deborah, that's a lovely name. Deborah in the scripture was a beautiful sister. My sister Deborah, you've been in this world for some time now, right? 70 years, my beautiful sister said. She doesn't even look past 30. But Deborah, I got a question, Deborah. You're 70 years on this earth. Have you learned that black people have enemies? Give me an example, because I'm a young man, right? The sister said the European system, right? She acknowledged that. You're right. But we're addressing external enemies now before we get to our nation, all right? Are there any external enemies? She knows the white, the European race, right? That's one. Is there any? Okay, the bar said there's nations in the world that are against God. We're going to leave that because for us to learn our enemies, you're going to learn today. God has enemies and God's children have enemies, those same enemies. Let's read that. Because this is what a man of God is supposed to do, not give you motivational speeches. He's supposed to read you the word of God because this is your protection. He's supposed to warn you on what to look out for. Read that. Psalms 83 verse 1. Keep not thou silence, O God. Hold not thy peace. This is the prophet David speaking because he was showing prophecies of things to come. And he was upset about something. Read. And be not still, O God, for lo, thine enemies make a tumult. Because the same nations back then, my sister, who were God's children's enemies, are the same nations today that are our enemies. So David was pissed at that thing back then. So he's saying, God, don't hold your silence no more. Don't be still. Do something. Read. And they that hate thee have lifted up their head. David said, the nations that hate you, God, have lifted up their head, meaning they've come into power. Right? Read. They have taken crafty counsel against thy people. David said, these nations are unified, and they're taking counsel against us, your people Israel. That's what he was mad about. Read. Consulted against thy hidden ones. They're consulting against us because today we're the hidden ones. We don't know that we're the children of God. We like our oppressive names or nationalities, or you're African American, or you're Haitian, or you're Colombian, Puerto Rican, Dominican. We like our pet names because they all came together and destroyed us and gave us new definitions, so we don't identify with our book anymore. But we don't. They have said, come, let us cut them off from being a nation. The nation said, and he's going to reveal who by the God. God-given name, because the names they go by today is not the names God gave them, right? But he said their goal was to cut off God's people from being a nation. So that's why when we look in the mirror today, we're confused. How is it that the same slave ship that dropped us off now is now different nationalities?
Right.
The slave ship that stopped here in North America, oh, we're African American. But they stopped in the Caribbean, you're Jamaican, you're Trinidadian, you're Guyanese, you're Bermudan. You see all the separation already? That's foolishness. God calls the Latinos, the Native Indians, and the Negroes the nation of Israel. We descend from 12 men. Over many years, we multiplied and became a nation of 12 tribes. 12 men, 12 sons equals 12 tribes equals one nation. You got that? That's the truth, but they came together with one consent. Read that again. They have said, come, let us cut them off from being a nation. That was the goal. Read. That the name of Israel may be no more in remembrance. That the name of Israel, we will not identify as a nation of Israel. You know what Israel means? We are princes of the power of God. When he says, my children are called by my name, that's what Israel means. We are the sons and daughters of God. That's what it means. But we don't want to call ourselves that. We're African Americans. Named after two Italian navigators that conquered lands and named it after themselves. That's foolishness. Or not Colombians, Venezuelans. Would you rather be, what do you identify with? African American? You're what? You're a child of who? You're a child of a king. Well, check this out. You're saying you're a child of a king, right? Right? Is it better to be a child of a king or a child of God? Which one? Well, guess what? In your repentances, the first step is to remember who you were. Before slavery, we were sons and daughters of the living God, or simply short, Israelites. That's what the Bible is about, right? But God is going to list the enemies, because don't lose focus. God's people are destroyed for lack of knowledge, right? We learn God has enemies. The enemies of God came together and attacked God's children. You understand what I'm saying? Because think about it. My brother, if I got beef with your father, right? Because in the world, we see this every day. You got any siblings?
Nah, I know of none.
All right, well, check this out. You have any siblings? Your only child? So let me show you how it used to work. I could have a beef with your brother, right? This was stuff I've seen and I've been a part of. I repented of it. Your brother attacked my cousin, for example, right? We're looking for him. We can't find him, but we run into your other brother. We will beat him up because all of that house became our enemy. You know what I'm saying? So the point is, these enemies of God are the enemies of God's children. They came together and they attacked and destroyed us. That's what God is revealing. Read. Verse 5. For they have consulted together with one consent. So you know what's funny? You never hear the Chinese nation crying out, oh, you guys have been abusing those slaves, those Negroes. Free them. Give them reparations. You don't hear that. Give them reparations. You don't hear the Arabs crying out for us. You don't hear the Chinese crying out for us. You don't hear the East Indians. Why? Because God is revealing they're part of the plan. They joined that plan. They're on one consent. Yeah, let's keep them in sin and just take their wealth. That's where they come to our communities, all these businesses. The nations that profit from us. Yeah, read. They are confederate against thee. Because down south, they try to give you, oh, let's destroy the Confederate monuments. Confederate and Union Army means the same. Means they're one accord. You're confederate, meaning you're those nations that's unified, you're one. Union means nation, a collection of nations being one. So when you say, oh, I'm not for the Confederate, but I like the Union, the North, it's the same hatred. That's why our people don't understand the Republican Party and the Democrat Party is one of the same. They're your oppressors.
America is racist anyway.
Correct, and that's what the sister was saying before. But the point is, did you vote? Do you believe in voting?
I didn't work for me. I work for myself.
No, but the practice.
I don't vote.
You don't, but guess what? Our people do, and it doesn't make sense for you to go to the same oppressive system to liberate yourself. That makes no sense. The The machine is built to keep you oppressed.
I was born by myself, I died by myself.
Well, you wasn't born by yourself. Somebody had to lay down, put some work in. All right, let's not get on the.
It's a three party.
Yeah. But brother, what's your name, by the way?
Dave.
Dave or Dan?
Dave.
Dave. Listen to this. Verse 6, the tabernacles of Edom. So God is listing the nation that are His enemies. He's listing them. But watch. Everybody going to be like, wait a minute, the nation of Edom, and there's a reason you don't recognize these names, because they changed their titles. Think about it. If we look at from the 1600s, right? You look on the old pictures of the slaves being sold, and it says Israelites for sale. And then onto the side, you see the nation of Edom, the Europeans. You see the nation of Ishmael, the Arabs, and Chinese. You'll be like, yo, hey, we're the people of God. It'll be that easy. So they have to go change the names. You know what? We can't be called Edomites anymore. You're gonna be France. I'm gonna be Russian. You're gonna be German. You're gonna be Italian, right? But you know what ties them all together? Caucasian. It's giving you where they're from, the Caucasus Mountains. Showing you that they have all these different nationalities, but they're one nation. That's what that Caucasian shows. You have American Caucasian, French Caucasian, German Caucasian, Italian Caucasian, Belgian Caucasian. You get the point? They're showing you, nah, we're one nation of people. And God calls it the nation of Edom. That's the top dog. Because right now, the European nation, or the nation of Edom, they're the world power. They rule the world.
But they're still separate. But they're separate. But they're still collective.
No, what's happening, prophecy is being fulfilled. No, they don't want to court because they understand they only have nuclear amongst themselves. So they know, listen, America, you'll be the captain of the ship. But we all wealthy and rich, so we good. But right now, they're fighting amongst each other. And that union is dismantling. And God prophetically says, the European nations over there on the east side, the eastern hemisphere, they're going to let go of nukes that's going to destroy this side of the world. Bible prophecy, but read on. The tabernacles of Edom and Ishmaelites. The Ishmaelites are the Arabs. Right, I'm going to give you that in Jerome next. The Ishmaelites are the Arabs. God's biblical name for them was Ishmaelites. They descend from Abraham's son Ishmael, right? You ask any Arab, they'll tell you, yeah, we're Ishmael people. You understand what I'm saying? Because guess what? The Arabs did not suffer slavery like the blacks, the native Indians, and the Negroes. Who am I missing? That's it, right? Yeah, the native Indians, the Negroes, and the Latinos. We suffered slavery, so we don't remember who we were before 1492. Slavery, our Latino brothers and native sisters, they've been in slavery over 105 years longer than us. You know what I'm saying? 1492 started with the conquerors, the conquistadors. They had the mistake for a long time, so they look at us, they're like, yo, my hair is different. Because they've been mixing for a while. So when they look at us, they say, nah, but guess what? You go to South America, what they don't show you on TV, majority of the true Latinos are dusty like you and I. They're Negroes, but they say, oh, no. Me no Negro, no. Yeah, exactly. Because they envy their oppressors. They want to be a Spaniard now. They want to be a white Spaniard that conquered them so bad. So they blonde their hair too. They wear the contacts. Just like the Negroes are doing too. Look, they wearing blonde wigs. That thing looks so ugly. Come on, man. God calls that color unclean. But my brother, we got to wrap it up, but we're going to finish with this right here, right?
I just want it here. It's good. Go ahead.
The Ishmaelites of Moab and the Hagarenes. So, also the African nation, the sons of Ham. Just because we're black like them, we're not the same people. Right? And that's what we have in love. We think everybody that's black is our people. No, they're not. Africans, the sons of Ham, rounded up the Israelites from the west coast of Africa along with the Arabs, and they sold us to the Europeans. And that's in Joel. But now we got to go. We got to wrap it up. But we got to shut down. So, my friend, you got a flyer?
Not even.
Give him a flyer. This is the board. Check the information out, all right?
Definitely.
Next time, come a little early. We out here every day, right? We're doing a 30-day camp. So check us out, all right?
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road. Purple and gold, from Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.